I talk to a lot of companies where I hear from the CIO or from the CTO, they say the technology is moving so fast that we cannot find the people in the market that have the skills. So if we can't find the people in the market that have the skills, we now have to change our recruiting strategy and we have to start training people internally to develop those skills. When we want to teach people about a new technology, we focus just on the tool. We grab you and we say, we're going to do a 2-hour meeting. We're going to teach you how to use this tool. And then we're going to expect you to use it. And it's very technical and it's very confusing. And when I work with organizations, I find that people are always interested, but you can't just overwhelm them with technical features and specifications right away. If you want to get higher adoption rates, you have to meet people where they are. And that means you might have a couple of sessions of training sessions where you just show people not just the tool that you're using, but some of the tools that are changing our world. There are several ways that these technologies are changing our concept of leadership. So on a very large and sort of broad level, our historical idea of what a CEO or what a leader should be is somebody that has all the answers. And they're expected to have all the answers. But now we are living in a world where the answers themselves are constantly changing because information is moving so fast. So one, you're starting to see that the idea of the role of a leader is somebody who knows all the answers to somebody who facilitates that their team can go and get all of the answers because they can't have all of the answers themselves. That's the first part. The second part is that there is what we call digital body language. So you can have all the policies in the world about your work-life balance or about what you want the technology to mean and about what you want to do with it. But oftentimes, employees will look to leaders and they will look at their leaders' digital behavior, how they're using the tools, if they're using the learning programs, and that's what they will mirror. I believe that every person is creative, and I define creativity as your capacity to do highly complex cognitive tasks. If you're analyzing or researching or reading or thinking or strategizing, all of those things require creativity. And it's more important than ever because as the world gets more competitive, the ways that companies are going to set themselves apart once we've become completely optimized, because for the last couple of years, we focus on optimization, automation, be as efficient as possible. Now everyone's efficient and everyone is optimized. So what is the next level? The next level is going to be that great idea. And it's very counterintuitive, but what we have to understand is that sometimes, even though everything else is going really fast, the best thing you can do is to just go a little bit slower and to create that space and time for your employers to think. I encourage all of you to do some of the work of reflecting about your own relationship with work, your own belief systems, your own ideas of your identity and who you are, because those are the things that are influencing your behavior at work more than any policies.